Before the tour, 8 blue-collar builders would accept a challenge. Build a rat rod in 30 days with a $3,000 budget and then drive it across the country. The official tour kicks off in the small town of Mattawa, Minnesota. From there, the northernmost group will drive 2 hours south to meet up with the rest of the Rat Rod magazine crew. The next morning, it's a 530-mile drive to St. Louis, where the tour and build-off will come together for the first time. After a few hours of uneasy sleep, the crew rises.
Morning.
There's a coffee shop across the street.
Morning, day one. Funky hair, pajamas.
This is my job. I'm gonna be in everyone's face.
Vehicles are gassed up and prepped for the first substantial leg of the journey, including the old Chevy Stepside, recently converted into the Rat Rod magazine mothership, appropriately nicknamed the Black Box.
Dancer David's gonna bless our tour.
Yeah. Except yeah. for him.
Yeah, yeah last year, same, pray that nobody would break down. I did.
And just like that, it's on.
It was a beautiful night and the stars lit up the sky.
Well, almost.
That's how we roll.
Wow. Just keep going.
I told my baby I'm taking my bike for a ride. Well, I let it rip going 95, feeling good, feeling alive.
Come on.
Oh, I smell more.
Ooh, that smells different.
An impromptu pit stop allows the guys to apply a Band-Aid or two and catch back up with the rest of the caravan.
How much time do I take off?
Looks like a fruit roll-up.
And then I saw something moving on down the line. I saw two eyes reflecting down the road. I hoped that it was only a horny toad. But then I sadly realized that thing got bigger and bigger in size. I slammed my brakes and oh no.
It doesn't take long for more gremlins to appear. But hey, it's all part of the journey. Sometimes, to truly appreciate the road, you have to stand beside it, or something like that.
I figured I'd live when I heard the ambulance. I thank the good Lord I've been given a second chance.
Navigator.
But the paramedics were in a hurry, so I got scared and started worrying when I realized it wasn't much left in my pants.
Guys,
telltale signs I did not escape unarmed. Well, it was quite a sight in the zipper place. I knew it was bad when I saw the dog's face. I'd assumed the worst, that I'd lost my lucky charm. And then I got good news regarding my dangling. It was still attached, so I smiled and started to sing. But the nurse quickly shook her head, said, "You got one ball hanging by a thread. You're a one ball daddy, and that's how things are gonna be. One ball daddy, what am I gonna do? One ball daddy, I lost a family jewel. How on earth will I tell my wife that I lost a ball?"
Early Sunday morning, Sam Shapiro, owner of Shapiro Steel, Steve Thamert, editor of Rat.Hard Magazine, Rat.Hard Magazine, and their respective crews set the table for a Rat.Hard feast called Steelfest. For the first time, the build-off cars that made it this far are all in the same place. This is also the first time the magazine staffs and judges have been able to meet the builders face to face. Six of the eight builders made it to St. Louis. Kyle, Sinful Steel. Robbie, Leighton Auto Body. Chris, In the Weeds Hot Rods. Casey, Casey's Customs. Dennis, Tom's Rat Rods. And Cody, the Rat Shop.
Let me be myself, girl. They say love is a virtue, oh girl, but not when it hurts you. It'll leave you blue, there's nothing you can do. And you've been there so many times, oh, so many times before. And all you got for the swam and dog.
As Steelfest slowly begins to wind down, a proper finale is on everyone's mind. And a crowd gathers on the street in anticipation. Even those who don't smoke their tires still exit in style. The next morning, tour-goers and build-off competitors alike will follow the Mississippi River south into Memphis, Tennessee. After a night of unwinding at a St. Louis icon called Shady Jack's, folks rise early to prepare their vehicles. Tour chaplain David Mulder has a bit more work to do than most after his fuel pump died the night before.
Which I wish I had
some. Yeah, because if that wire sits there and bounces and wiggles, it might short out.
See how melted that is? That was in the tank where we were going down the highway.
Build-off teams get a much-needed chance to tweak their machines.
What are we doing, Dennis?
Doing my dishes. Gotta have my protein shake, and I forgot to clean it yesterday. It looks like a damn mud inside there. Something was crawling in.
Original.
Oh, sweet. Dude. Look at this.
The whole harness.
Good, we won't have to solder nothing.
No soldering, no shrink wrap, no nothing.
Good morning. We're here with Team Sinful Steel. It's Monday. Get ready to roll out from Memphis. These guys had a couple challenges so far with some welds breaking, but they got those all fixed up at Shapiro's last night. How are you guys feeling about today?
Good. Feeling good.
Yeah.
Ready to get on the road and get all this group of guys rolling.
Every gas stop is an opportunity to wrench on something or grab a snack. Though competitors, the build-off crews work together to make sure everyone finishes the drive.
Flatten it out, we're gonna bend it up here.
After a nightcap at a local racing legend's man cave, the tour heads across town to spend the day with a popular parts manufacturer.
You ready for a ride today?
Yeah, we're going to Com Camps today. It's going to be a great day. Now the brain's all done.
I'm so hammered. I've been wasted for years. Don't know the difference between smiles and my tears. And I smoke so much so that I don't think. Sleep so deep so that I won't dream. It could have been so good. It could have been so good. Walking around, nothing to say. Hanging around for a another day. Search my soul for a skeleton. Could have jumped right out of my skin. Cause it could have been so good.
Empty space, but if you
want to stay in my wall,
now it's
driven
racing.
What's
your mission
here?
Can you give me an example?
Well, send me off and turn me loose, and mother always lock and load. Then take me up and dust me off, a little sister got the road. Cause I was made for high volume dealing, baby, wanna steal the show. Well, all I need is gasoline to fill me and a match to blow.
Most of the group heads to Beale Street, Memphis' famous main drag, to show off their rides and socialize with the locals.
Pretty badass. Simple question. Just what do you think of these rides?
I think these are awesome.
What do you think? Met up in St. Louis, so all these drove from St. Louis, and now we're taking them to Louisiana. So
they're pretty cool.
Yeah, they're great. I like it. It's like art on wheels to me.
Totally.
And I mean, what they do to the cars, it's just great.
Night ends with some much-needed downtime at the nearby Dan McGuinness Pub.
I got my long rock Canadian. Where?
At daybreak, the tour will make its final 7-hour push to the big finale in Alexandria, Louisiana.
I didn't come here to please you. I didn't come here to tease you. I just need a quiet place to sit. I've been waiting on my train to take me back home again, to figure out just where I have been. These nights can be cold, a soul can be sold for a million.
You want to give me a report so far?
Report is tour kicks ass this far.
Awesome.
Awesome.
I love it. If I could follow, I would.
Get Clark back on there. He ain't missed a tour yet. He can't be on the fly.
What happened?
And the welder is not nowhere around, so we're gonna do this to get to the next stop.
Yeah, it's me. How's your ride so far?
Good.
Good?
Yep. Having a blast.
Man, this is the coolest shit I ever seen. Man, I can't believe my ass right now. This shit is awesome.
All I need to know is, what do you think of this stuff?
Man, this shit cool.
Fueled by the energy of the locals and the anticipation of reaching Louisiana, the tour rolls on. The crew reaches the beautiful Park England Hotel in Alexandria. Of the six build-off competitors that left St. Louis, all of them made it. Even the black box limped in, barely.
I mean, I'm going 20 and... Yeah. I mean, you basically...
So I can imagine you
basically
not...
Basically nothing.
So what's wrong? No brake fluid. That probably...
That would do
reason
it.
It doesn't want to stop.
Yeah.
Or at least low brake fluid.
But here's the question, where's it going?
A longer 3/8-inch wrench would be heaven right now.
As the team tends to the fleet, Rat.Rod magazine editor Steve Thamer interviews the build-off judges one by one. Choosing a winner won't be easy.
You've got the guys from Sinful who just one problem after another, but man, they persevered. It was their first car build, not their first Rat.Rod build, but their first car build. Yeah. They're kind of bike guys, but they put this together, this truck, and this happened and that happened, and just kept getting over the hump each time.
Second filter we put on.
That's some nasty stuff.
I'd give him one hell of a high five, because that's to tackle something like this. He deserves a good game.
Casey, with he turned in his scrap to get money to finish his bill.
Recycling.
Yeah. I was so impressed by that, you know.
Casey's Customs, another post-war car, kind of a unique concept. Yeah, the late model Caprice chassis. You can just take the Fairlane body and just slam it on top, like taking a couple busted up model cars and making something. That was cool.
So, I mean, it's on the verge of going to the next level on that car, but it's I would not pass it up.
I hear the Lowrider song every time I look at that thing.
You know? They're so close. You got Cody Stack, whose car was just flawless. Didn't have one hiccup, one problem. I think he used a half quart of oil on the way down here, and that's it.
There's a lot of cool stuff on that one. So, and last night when I was looking over them, there was stuff I was just, there's a lot of stuff I just looked all over. Even my kid was like, oh man, look at this.
Layton build was actually pretty cool for his first one that he's ever done. Mm-hmm. He's come through with it. It's very roadworthy, very safe.
Made it.
it made it. I mean, that's a long, long trek to do. I kind of like it. It's low, mean, and one ratty machine.
What I have to say about it all is each one of them were so unique and had so much to look at and so much to be proud of for these guys, because they all made it.
Dennis Hom's car is just cool. I mean, he's a Texas guy, he's got Texas details all throughout it. Another flawless running car. He's got the big skeleton hands holding up the exhaust.
Dennis, that thing. Just,
he's a great dude.
Oh yeah.
He's a lot of fun.
He's a lot of fun. He's been giving me hassles, just whatever. But that's how he is. He's a great guy.
And Dennis's car.
And Dennis's car is because it's so unique. And I consider all this sculpture. I'm kind of got a sculpture background. And he put so much heart into it as far as his personality. And it is his truck, his car.
He took the time to build those little hands to hold those pipes. He had to have the brackets, but he took the time to build like some hands up there. I mean, and then it just looks, they're just right. I don't know, I just can't tell you, they're just right to me.
Was there anything else about these other cars, anything else that just jumped out at you where you're like, wow, it's so cool?
Dennis's attention to detail, the dirty Rat.Rod details, the hands, the copper, all like that.
Brian knows a thing or two about details. He's been tasked with building the last three magazine flagship vehicles and driving each one of them across the country.
They all did a wonderful job, but it's going to be really tough to sit down and fine tooth comb and see who comes out on top, really.
The 57, because it's so unique, I mean, it looks, there's so many different aspects of it. It's unique, it looks fast, it looks like some sort of a disturbed, funny car.
57 is hard to, it's hard to deny that one, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. So I probably, and basically for the same reasons.
What do you think, Jerry?
Man, for me, I mean, visually that car, it's just, when we were in the parking lot at the pub, I mean, I was out there taking pictures of cars, and there ain't a bad angle on that car.
Just to have a car that was rusted, nothing left to hold it together, and put a car together with it,
right.
That's amazing.
Yep.
You know, as a builder myself, that right there is just, I commend him on that.
It's almost a shame we have to pick a winner out of all these guys.
I know. It's like, hold on. By making it here and driving around like we are, every one of them are winners.
Next day, the group visits the Central Louisiana Food Bank. All of the money raised through the Cajun Nationals event goes right here to help those in need. Waiting for her ball to come back to pick up a spare. It's also another opportunity to show off the cars and interact with the locals.
Yeah, like this, stuff like that. This car is really, really old. Look at the inside.
The food bank distributes about 6 million pounds of food each year. It's all donated food that we receive from a variety of sources. Through the smoke-filled air, made the men drool and the women glare with a frame like that. If they're hot for anyone to resist.
These are awesome. It looks like y'all saved them and turned them into something they can never be.
As the show approaches, cars begin rolling into town from all over the place, bringing their stories with them.
We built this car for Swamp Stomp this year, because all of our proceeds go to Make-A-Wish Foundation, and we raffled off this car.
Really?
We made like $25,000 on it, gave the car away. The man that won it gave it back to us and said, bring it to the shows with you and display it.
1, 2, 3, 4!
On the morning of the show, the two builders who didn't make the drive show up with their crippled machines. Bobby Meadows' 1940 Ford, powered by a bulldozer engine, gave in to its gremlins. And Brian Swinner's 1941 Chevy, as cool as it was, suffered the same fate.
smell like dead alligator.
He's larger than life. He comes out the jeans and he smokes like he strikes. He comes like a billy, but he ain't square. He drives a hopper car and he pop a doors his hair. He plays a mean guitar and a doghouse bass. You meet him on the black of you, you know you're gonna race. He drives a bass, damn it, it ain't slow. A juicy nose can ride with a top good low. It's chopped down and it's hopped up. It's chopped down and it's hopped up. It's chopped down and it's hopped up.
It's fair to say these crazy Cajunists put on one hell of a show.
He's gonna make you look if you don't take care. Don't look him in the eye and you best not stare. But if you wanna ride, you better prove to be smooth. You better wear your seatbelt cause that lot of lame moves. It's chopping down and it's hopped up. It's chopping down and it's hopped up. It's chopping down.
Jeff's got the big stuff out now and it ain't his wiener.
During the show, folks are invited to take part in a hot sauce drinking contest.
I'm already sweating, just a thought.
It's horrible to throw up.
Set, go! Go, Josh! Go, Josh! Thank you, guys. Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner!
We're going to hand you a boat full of grappling. When we say go, whoever gets up first is the winner.
From hot sauce, they jump right into a local favorite called crackling.
First one to fall right back.
These boys from Texas, well, as you can see, they'll eat anything.
This is your lovely prize. We have a fat pig for you.
Eat it. Oh, and my twin.
Crackling eating chicken right here.
What is crackling?
I believe it's pig fat.
So bacon.
Essentially, but it's fried.
It's fried pig fat.
You see all this seasoning? Look.
Even the Rat Rod magazine mascot, Matt the Rat, made it to Louisiana. Capping off the first day is a tattoo-filled after-party. What better way to commemorate a grand adventure than with a little ink?
I think it's wonderful. I think I don't have far to go in it. I'm
yeah.
close to home.
Yeah, we do.
I'm very close to home. My car might not like it, but I don't mind.
Give me a weather report.
Rain with a chance of rain.
Very good. So you driving that thing on the road tonight?
Oh yeah, all the way home.
All right.
Rain or shine.
The award portion of the show kicks off with a round of meaningful tributes. There's a very personal and heartfelt undertone to the whole process, and plenty of love is dished out. Soon, it's Rat-Hard's turn.
They made it the whole drive with their 30-day, $3,000 bill from St. Louis to Alexandria. And we give a round of applause for these boys.
These guys are hardcore. So, what we got here is exactly what it took to do what these guys done. A big set of brass balls.
Build-off contestants collect individual trophies and awards, each victorious in their own way.
All right, before we get to the big winners, that's right, I said winners, because the top two judges and public vote winners will be on the cover simultaneously of Rat.Hard Magazine and Rat.Hard Magazine, another thing that has never been done before, but we're going to do it. We wanted to say thank you, first of all, to all the people here, everybody at the Cajun Nationals, with all the hospitality. This has been awesome. The runner-up of the 2013 Rat.Hard Build-Off is Dennis Hahn. The winner of the 2013 Rat.Hard Build-Off Drive-Off is Chris Walker.
And just like that, the winners are crowned.
Oh my God. What? Kill that off.
With one last surprise from the builders, the build-off officially ends. Build-off teams and tour goers scatter as they head for home.
We're doing a long trip back to Canada.
Slowed by major electrical problems, the black box lags behind. Times like these, well, they put things in perspective and allow for meaningful reflection. In only a couple of days, the rest of the Northern group will ferry across the Mississippi and make their way back to Minnesota and Canada.
Oh yeah, fun stuff.
And after a long night of creative problem solving by some clever Cajuns, even the stragglers would eventually make it home. After completely losing their minds, that is.
Jesus.
What the?
I've been getting shots of his ass the whole day, so.
Oh, nice!
Yeah.
Now you get the front of my ass.
Oh!